South Africa has been deeply affected by the scars of apartheid, and the effects are still visible, be it in the education sector, jobs, or the one which we are going to talk about in this video, sports. In 1970, the then ruling white government in South Africa came up with the policy of apartheid, which basically segregated white people from the non-whites. It was implied in sports too, especially in cricket and rugby. The non-whites were not allowed to feature in the national teams or play against the whites. This apartheid policy led to the boycott of South Africa from the international sporting scene. The ban was revoked only in 1991 when the country discontinued its practice of apartheid. But even after 27 years, there aren't enough representation of non-white players in the national cricket and rugby teams. And when it comes to black players, it's even worse. The blacks make up for 80% of South Africa's population, while the whites and colored ones make up 8.4% and 8.8% of population of the country respectively. 100 players have played in Test cricket for South Africa since 1991, of which only 7 of them have been black Africans. Due to the continuous pressure of the ANC government to get an even representation, Cricket South Africa came up with a very radical transformation policy in 2016. It stated that the Proteas team is going to field 6 non-white cricketers, of which 2 will always be black players. Though whites dominate the game of cricket and rugby in South Africa, and non-whites should be given better facilities and opportunities, but getting quotas in the playing 11 will definitely affect the performance of the team. Aren't the Cricket South Africa is putting an extra burden on its captain of choosing a competitive playing 11, keeping in mind the racial quotas? You decide whether the quotas are the right method for non-white people's empowerment or not.